तो वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू आपके, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आर द वॉइस एंड स्क्रीन क्लियर? एवरीवन रिप्लाई अगेन, आर द वॉइस एंड स्क्रीन क्लियर? यस ऑल ओके। ऑल राइट, कैन यू हियर मी नाउ? यस ओके। सो विच एग्जाम्पल वी डिड लास्ट टाइम, बराबर नो विच एग्जाम्पल वी डिड 13? 13 14 ओके। So today we will solve further examples, okay? Today we will solve the further examples. So write down example number 15. Write down example number 15. Let's see what is given there and let's find out the answer. Fourteen is over. 15. The potential difference across a wire of 10^-3 centimeter square cross sectional area. You are given a wire. Having cross sectional area 10^-3 centimeter square and 50 centimeter length is two hold. Potential difference across wire of area A length L is two holds. Don't write plural form of the unit. Do not write plural form of the unit, okay? It is simply volt is enough. Or you may write it like two volts. Two volt. When the current of 0.25 ampere exists in the wire. Okay, this was the situation when the current of 0.25 ampere exists in the wire. Calculate field strength in the wire. Field strength means electric field. Field strength in wire. Yes, inside wire. Will there be electric field? Yes. Because this is not an electrostatics case. Charges are in motion. This is current electricity. Current density. Second is current density. Second is current density. Third is conductivity. Third is conductivity. Conductivity of not wire, conductivity of material of wire. Conductivity, resistivity are the property of material. Resistance, conductance are the property of material plus dimensions. Resistance, conductance are the properties of material plus dimensions. Conductivity, resistivity are the properties of material only. Conductivity of material of wire. So the formula that you are going to use for field strength, that is equal to electric field inside the wire, field strength E is equal to V upon D, potential difference you are given, and the length across which this potential difference exists, that also you are given. The potential difference across the wire is V and the length of the wire is L. So V upon L, V upon D equals V upon L. So find out electric field strength. V is 2 volt upon length is 50 centimeter. So 50 as it is, centi means 10 raised to minus 2. So that will become minus 2 in the numerator, 200, 200 upon 50, that is equal to 4. You can write volt per meter, SI unit, right? V upon D, SI unit, everything in SI unit. Volt per meter, V upon D or V upon L, volt per meter. Or you could have written Newton per coulomb, force per unit charge. That is also okay. Next is current density. Current density J is equal to current per unit area. You know the current, you know the area. 0.25 divided by area is 10 raised to minus 3. Minus 3 in the numerator, that becomes plus 3. 1000 means this decimal point will shift rightward by 3 times, or by 3 digits. So that's the current density. Current per unit area. Current per unit area, ampere per meter square. Current per unit area, ampere per meter square. Next, what is asked? Here, conductivity. Now, how to find out conductivity? Very simple. J is known, E is known. J is known, E is known. You can write J is equal to sigma into E. You can write J is equal to sigma into E. J is proportional to E and proportionality constant is sigma. J is equal to sigma into E. J is proportional to E. Sir, J is equal to 2.5 into 10 raised to 6. Any mistake? Yes. Area is not only 10 raised to minus 3, it is in centimeter square. So this is 10 raised to minus 3. Centimeter means 10 raised to minus 2 meter, but it is to be squared. It is to be squared. That's my area. So this 250 as it is. Or 0.25 as it is. Divided by 10 raised to minus 3. Minus 2 raised to 2 is minus 4. Minus 3 minus 4 is minus 7. And this in the numerator. 0.25 into 10 raised to plus 7. Ampere per meter square. Arrange decimal point generally after first digit. Point moving left plus 1, right minus 1. Point moving right minus 1. It shifted by one digit towards right. So 2.5. Point moving right minus 1. Plus 7 minus 1. Plus 6. Ampere per meter square. Ampere per meter square. Now here you can find out conductivity by saying that, or by using microscopic form of Ohm's law. V is equal to IR is the macro, big, macroscopic. But J is equal to sigma into E is micro, MI, microscopic form of Ohm's law. J is also known, E is also known. So sigma is equal to J upon E. Sigma is equal to J upon E. What is J? J is equal to this. So sigma is equal to J is 2.5 into 10 to the power 6 divided by E. E is 4. 2.5 upon 4, not a big deal. 0.625, you can figure out this division, into 10 raised to 6. Now what shall be the unit of sigma? Unit of resistivity. Unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Unit of conductivity. Conductivity is 1 upon resistivity. Conductivity is 1 upon resistivity. So 1 upon ohm meter. So 1 upon ohm meter, that's the unit. That's the unit. Okay, this is one of the ways to find out sigma. Second way is also there. What you can do is, no, actually there is no second way. Actually there is. R is equal to rho L upon A. This R is unknown. This rho is also unknown. L is known, A is known. So rho can be written as 1 upon sigma. Sigma is to be found out. And the resistance of the wire, can be written as potential difference upon current. Potential difference upon current. V is given, I is given, sigma is to be found out. Sigma is to be found out, so sigma equal to question mark, you can write. L is known, A is known. Reply in the chat box. Is this second way clear to all of you? Second way to find out sigma, because everything else is given. Sigma in this way also you can find out. Or by using this. Both will give you same answer. Everyone. Done. Clear and written. Okay. Chalo. Next. Question number 16. There are two wires of same length. Will it J equal to E into sigma after rearrangement? Yes, it will become obviously. How can you ask like it? This is equal to J is equal to sigma into E. Why not? This is actually going to be J equal to sigma into E, because this relation has been derived. R is equal to rho L upon A has been derived from this, or from microscopic form of Ohm's law, or from I is equal to N E A B D. Everything started from here. Okay. The first thing that we derived was the drift velocity. The second thing was I is equal to N E A B D, and then all other things started. So even origin of this formula, everything lies here. Okay. So definitely after rearrangement it will become J is equal to sigma into E. Here after rearrangement you will get this J equal to sigma into E. Next. Two wires. There are two wires of same length. L1 equal to L2. And same material. Material same, so resistivity same. Material same, resistivity same. Because material same. because material same. The ratio of their specific resistance is ratio of specific resistance. Ratio of specific resistance is equal to question mark. What is this vichar like question? Now specific resistance ratio will be what? Reply me in the chat box. Two wires of same length, same material, and the radii. First has radius equal to r, and second has radius is equal to 2r. Wire A, wire B. Ratio of specific resistance will be what? Fast, everyone. That's very easy question. What is the answer? Ratio of specific resistance. Hola. Solve this question and tell me the answer. Everyone, fast. Ansh, Prasad, everyone. Others, where are others? Ratio of specific resistance. 1/16. But specific resistance means what? Resistivity. Resistivity. Specific resistance. तुम्हाला resistance चा ratio नाही विचारला. आम्ही तुम्हाला resistivity चा ratio विचारला. Specific resistance means resistivity. This name has been already given to you. They are just checking whether you know this name or not. So ratio of specific resistance rho 1 upon rho 2 is equal to 1 because rho 1 is equal to rho 2 because same material, because both wires have same material. Same material. Specific resistance or resistivity is the property of material. Specific resistance or resistivity is a property of material. Material, they have kept same for both the wire. Wire A and B, they have kept material same. So resistivity will be same. Okay. Next. Question number 17. Question number 17. The resistance of wire is 50 pi. The resistance of wire is 50 pi. Then the graph between V, log V and log I. Graph between log V and log I is graph between log V and log I. Option straight line passing through origin. Straight line passing through origin. Option B, parabola. Option C, hyperbola. Option D, none of the above. Option D, none of the above. Okay, first of all, arrange, or first of all, think what is the relation between V and I. Then arrange log V and log I in the equation. V is equal to IR. That's the relation between V and I. Arrange log V, taking log on both these sides. Log of I into R. Log MN is log M plus log N. Log MN is log M plus log N. That's the log b. This entire bracket we are going to plot on y-axis, log b. This entire bracket we are going to plot on x-axis, plus this is a constant. This is a constant resistance of given wire. That's a fixed value. That's a fixed value. Okay. So that will become y is equal to, implies that this y is equal to slope. This entire quantity we are going to plot on x-axis, log I, 1 into log I. 1 into log I. So what I can say is this. Most of you have got the answer also. Check kara, alay ka tumhala answer. Log v can be written as log I plus log r. This is equal to y, this is equal to x, this is equal to some constant. Of course you can write here 1, and for that 1 you can write the slope of the line. So definitely it's not a straight line passing through origin. It's a straight line, but it's not a straight line passing through origin. You have this y coordinate. You have this y coordinate. The graph will be straight line, but won't be passing through origin. It has a y coordinate log r, log of 50 pi. That's the y coordinate. Slope, it has slope equal to 1. Log I is x, its coefficient is 1. So slope equal to 1. 1 means tan 45. So this angle is going to be equal to 45 degree. Because only then it will be equal to tan 45 is equal to 1. Slope of the line. This is the line passing through origin. This is going to be the graph between log V and log I. So answer we have to choose this option D. Reply in the chat box, clear and written, CW. It's a straight line but not passing through origin because it has y intercept, log r. This value will be log r. TTSL value, log r. Log r. चलो नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज डिपेंडेंस ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस ऑन द वेरियस फैक्टर्स. ओके लेट इट बी, लेट्स राइट इट. काय दिले बघूया. डिपेंडेंस ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस ऑन वेरियस फैक्टर्स, दिस वी वेरी इजीली नो एक्चुअली. Or sorry, this we already know actually. Write down dependence of resistance on various factors. Dependence of resistance on various factors. On various factors. Dependence of resistance on various factors. First of all, write R is equal to rho L upon A. Now they have replaced the value of rho. They have replaced the value of rho by mass of electron divided by N e square tau. But no need to remember that. Okay. No need to remember this. No need to remember the formula for rho. Okay. They have written it like this, but this is not required to be remembered. Okay.
जो formula मी आधी दिले होते.
ये formula तुम्ही लक्षात ठेवा. A as per the need you can, this as per the need you can derive or reach up to this. Okay. So R is proportional to L.
is proportional to 1 upon area.
Proportional to L, proportional to 1 upon area. Then proportional to 1 upon, proportional to 1 upon number density. Proportional to 1 upon tau. Proportional to 1 upon tau. Mass of electron is a fixed quantity. Charge on electron is a fixed quantity. So proportional to L, proportional to 1 upon area, proportional to 1 upon tau, proportional to 1 upon N.
Okay. Now
they have said, they have written one statement. The statement is this: in metals, as temperature rises, the relaxation time tau decreases. If relaxation time tau decreases, means time required for successive collisions decreases. That time decreases means more number of collisions happen. Time for one collision decrease means more number of collisions happen in given time. Okay. Implies number of collisions increase. Number of collisions of electrons with others. Electrons are trying to flow from one location to another location, and the collision number of collisions have now increased. If you increase the temperature of metals, number of collisions increase. Implies that here also you can observe, if tau decreases, temperature increase, tau decrease, temperature increase, time required for successive collision decreased. So that will increase number of collisions, and ultimately resistance will increase. Tau decrease, resistance increase. So resistance of the metals increases with temperature. So for metals with rise in temperature, ultimately number of collisions of electrons with the atoms increase. So therefore the resistance increases. So for metals, if you try to apply the concept of temperature coefficient of resistance, then that temperature coefficient of resistance should be positive value and not negative. Because with rise in temperature, resistance increases. So temperature coefficient of resistance should be a positive number. Okay. So you can write it like this also. They have not written there, but we can do this. R is equal to R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha delta theta or alpha delta t. Okay. And of course, you can write it like this. R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha into delta t will be final temperature minus initial temperature. Initial temperature is going to be 0. Initial resistance we are taking, resistance at 0 degree Celsius. So what are the things here we have written? R is resistance at T degree Celsius. R0 is resistance at 0 degree Celsius. And this alpha is temperature coefficient of resistance. Alpha is going to be a positive number, and here also we are using a positive sign. It means with rise in temperature, resistance increases. With fall in temperature, resistance decreases. For metals. This is true for metals only, not for semiconductors. Temperature coefficient of resistance. Just keep on writing additional things. Temperature coefficient of resistance. Okay. If wire is stretched,
If wire is stretched, wire stretch वाले example जरा सुनिए. Volume conserved. Volume conserved. So R is equal to rho L upon H in case जेव्हा असेल बघा. What are the possible options? Rho L upon area can be replaced by two possibilities are there. You can replace area. If length data is given, area can be replaced. If volume data, if area data is given, length can be replaced. Length sa data dila tar area la replace kara. Area sa data dila tar length la replace kara. Rho L upon area can be replaced by volume upon length. And here, if area data is given, area is doubled or radius data is given means ultimately area data you are given. Radius data dila manje ultimately area sa data dila asto tumhala. In that case, you can replace length by volume upon area. Length can be replaced by volume upon area. Length can be replaced by volume upon area. Rho as it is, this A as it is. So this R becomes rho L square upon volume, and this R becomes rho volume upon A square. Okay. So rho and volume both are constant. So R proportional to L square. Volume and rho both are constant, so R proportional to 1 upon A square. R proportional to 1 upon A square. These are the two possible cases for the stretching of wire. Dependence of resistance means how resistance will change if you stretch the wire. If you stretch the wire, either it will be proportional to L square or it will be inversely proportional to 1 upon A square. Check which case is given to you. If volume if length data is given, keep the length as it is, replace the area by volume upon length. If area data is given, replace the length by volume upon area. Replace the length by volume upon area. Okay. Next. Next is effect of percentage change in the length of wire. Effect of percentage change in length of wire. Effect of percentage change in length of wire due to stretching. Wire stretch ke liye length change hali. Find out change in length, find out percentage change in length, and what is its effect. Let's see what they have written. They have written it like this. R 2 upon R 1 is equal to R 2 upon R 1 is equal to this equation they are going to use, right? We shall write it as L2 upon L1 or L2 square or L2 upon L1 bracket square. Why not this? L2 upon L1 bracket square. Why not this? L2 upon L1 bracket square. L2 can be written as L1 original length plus X percent of original length. This is the increase in length. X percent, 5% of original length is the increase in the length. So this increase in the length and this is the original length divided by L1. X percent is the increase in length. Is the increase in length. So this is the original length plus original cha x percent, x upon 100. That's the increase in length, percentage change in length. So x percent is the increase in the length. Therefore, R2 upon R1 If x, if there is an increase in length, put x positive. If there is decrease in length, put x negative. Okay. If there is decrease in length, put x negative. Or instead of saying increase here, you can write change. You can write change. And you know, change always has sign, final minus initial. So it will be always having sign, either plus or minus. So here, yes, you have to write the square. Yes, sir, here you have to write the square. Okay. L1, L1 common. L1, L1 common. In the bracket, 1 plus x upon 100, that's what they have written. That's what they have written, divided by L1 square. L1 square, L1 square cancel. L1 square, L1 square cancel. This square shall remain as it is. L1, L1 common, L1 square. 1 plus x upon 100 square. 1 plus x upon 100 square. L1 square, L1 square cancel. That remains 1 plus x upon 100 bracket square. And if this x is very, very small compared with the 100, then it is going to be a fraction. And they have written like written it like this. If x is less than 5, then R2 upon R1 is equal to 1 plus fraction raised to n wala logic. 1 plus, this is going to be the fraction because x value is around 5 or less than 5. So 5 upon 100 is 0.005. That's a value which is very, very less than 1. 1 plus fraction raised to n is 1 plus n times fraction. 1 plus 2 times x upon 100. You can of course make it as 2 upon 50. Sorry, 1 upon 50. 2 by 100 is 1 by 50. That's it. That's what they have written. This is R2 upon R1. This is R2 upon R1. Final resistance upon initial resistance. Okay. Now let's say we want to find out percentage change in resistance. Percentage change in resistance. R2 upon R2 minus R1 upon R1 into 100. That's what we want to, let's say, find out. In that case, what we will do is this. I can write R2 upon R1 is equal to 1 plus 2x upon 100 divided by 1. This is a numerator. This is denominator. Numerator minus denominator upon denominator. Numerator minus denominator upon denominator. Numerator minus denominator upon denominator. So that is R2 minus R1 upon R1 is equal to 1 minus 1 cancel. 2x upon 100 upon 1 is 2x upon 100. 2x upon 100. And percentage change in resistance, R2 minus R1 upon R1 into 100 is equal to 2x upon 100 into 100. 100 cancel. The answer will be 2 times x percent. If the length increases by x percent, resistance increases by 2 times x percent. Length zar x percent na increase zali, change zali, the resistance 2 times x percent na change hota. Agree, disagree, reply me in the chat box. Because R proportional to L square. After this step, there is approximation. After this step, there is approximation. Up to this, everything is accurate. Everything is accurate without any approximation. Up to this. After this, there is approximation. Sir, instead of doing all this stuff, if you are going to apply the approximation, you could have done this also. If you are going to apply the approximation, means for small changes. Now the change is now less than 5%. That is going to be a small change. Write down, for small change, for a small change in length, for small change in length, r proportional to l square. एवढं तर माहित आहे. For small change in length, r proportional to l square implies that error वाले rules, approximation वाले rules, delta r upon r is equal to 2 times delta l upon l, that we can do. Delta r upon r is equal to 2 times delta l upon l. What is this? Delta r upon r is equal to 2 times delta l. Delta r upon r into 100 is equal to 2 times delta l upon l into 100. Percentage change in resistance is equal to 2 times percentage change in length. Is equal to 2 times percentage change in length. That we could have written directly. Then, next, question number 18. Question number 18. Directly पण approximation ची rule वापरता आले असते ना. R proportional to L square. Delta R upon R is equal to 2 times delta L upon L. Can you recall those rules? If there is any physical quantity X which is proportional to X raised to A, Y raised to B, then delta Z upon Z will be equal to, forget about proportionality now because you are taking a ratio. Delta Z upon Z is A times delta X upon X plus B times delta y upon y. If you are calculating errors, even if this is a negative number, take this as a positive number. Even if this is a negative number, take this as a positive number if you are calculating error. But if you are calculating changes, then if it is negative, take it negative. If it is positive, take it positive. Here we are calculating change in the resistance. Changes we are calculating here and not the errors, and not the errors in the measurement. We are calculating changes. So if this is a positive number, take this positive. If it is a negative number, take this negative. So automatically everything will manage. If the value of x has increased, take delta x positive. If the value of x has decreased, take delta x negative. If value of y has increased, take delta y positive. If value of y decreased, take delta y negative. Means everything will carry a sign when you are saying change, everything will carry sign, plus or minus. Next, question number 18. Question number 18. If the wire is stretched to double its length, find the new resistance if the original resistance of the wire was R. Wire is stretched to new length. So you could have directly written L2 is equal to 2 times L1. Find out new resistance. R2 is equal to question mark. If the old resistance R1 is equal to R. Now, you know, R is equal to rho L upon A. It's a stretching case. Length data is given. Length data is given. So area will be replaced. Rho L. Area will be replaced by volume upon length. So rho, this length in the numerator, rho L square upon volume. Rho constant, volume constant, R proportional to L square. Now here do not do any kind of approximation. Okay. Here do not do any kind of approximation. Here find out exact answer because that is possible to find out here. R1 upon R2 is equal to L1 upon L2 bracket square. Put the values. L2 is equal to 2 times L1. L1 as it is, L2 is equal to 2 times L1 bracket square. L1, L1 cancel. 1 by 2 square is 1 by 4. Reciprocal on left hand side. R2 by R1. Reciprocal on right hand side implies that R2 is equal to 4 times R1. R2 is equal to 4 times R1, and R1 value, it is given as small capital R. So R2 value will be 4 times capital R. That's it. reply me in the chat box, clear and written. Within 30, 40, 50 seconds, you should get the answers. Question read korun, solve korun, tick kare parin. 30, 40, 50 seconds max. Even less than 1 minute, you shall get the answer. Next. If you have any doubt, you can ask me, okay? No problem. I'm just solving the examples, okay? And in this chapter, we are going to do the same thing. Small theory examples. Just get familiar with the type of examples. That is enough. Theory is always a smaller section. And examples is actually a larger section, okay? In this chapter at least, you can see that. And it is true for other chapters as well. Because most of the points get cleared from the examples. Because meaning of single line in the theory is actually 3 to 5 examples. थेरी मधली एक किंवा दोन लाईन ज्या असतात ते एक्झाम्पल मध्ये दोन किंवा तीन एक्झाम्पलच्या काउंट मध्ये कव्हर होतात. दोन तीन टाइपचे एक्झाम्पल्स तयार होऊ शकतात त्याच्यावरती. सो इट्स बेटर टू सॉल्व द एक्झाम्पल्स. नंबर 19. इफ द वायर इज स्ट्रेच टू इनक्रीज इज लेंथ बाय 1%. डेल्टा एल अपॉन लेंथ इनक्रीज झाली आहे प्लस 1% असं लिहिणार. Wire is stretched to increase its length by 1%. So delta L upon L will be equal to length increase zali hai, so plus 1%. Delta L upon L plus 1%.
1/100. Find out percentage change in resistance.
Delta R upon R into 100 is equal to question mark. Kai vicharle? परसेंटेज चेंज इन रेजिस्टन्स म्हणजे काय विचारले. डेल्टा आर अपॉन आर इंटू 100 इज इक्वल टू क्वेश्चन मार्क. परसेंटेज चेंज इन रेजिस्टन्स आय नो फॉर द स्ट्रेचिंग वाली केस आर इज इक्वल टू रो एल अपॉन ए. आय एम गिवन द लेंथ डेटा सो आय विल रिप्लेस व्हॉल्यूम एरिया डेटा. लेंथ एज इट इज एरिया कॅन बी रिप्लेस बाय व्हॉल्यूम अपॉन लेंथ. That will become rho into L square upon volume. But rho and volume are constant. Material is not changed while stretching the wire. When we are going to stretch the wire, material is not going to change. So rho will remain same. Volume is going to be constant. It's a stretching wali case. So R proportional to L square. For small changes, 1% is a small change. Up to 5% they have written. So 1% is less than 5%. For small changes, this proportionality can be written like this. Delta R upon R, proportionality gone, equality, 2 times delta L upon L. Sir, into 100, this is what we are asked. So delta R upon R into 100 is equal to 2 times delta L upon L into 100 on left hand side. So into 100 on right hand side. 2 times as it is. Delta L upon L. It is 1%. It is 1 upon 100. Into 100 as it is. That many percent. 100 cancel. Answer is 2%. Delta R upon R into 100 is equal to 2%. That's a positive number. So delta R is a positive value. So resistance has increased. If it came out to be negative, minus 2% means delta R is negative. Resistance has decreased. Reply me in the chat box, clear and written. CW.
keep on solving the examples. Should not be the big deal for us. We can directly say this approximation if x is less than 5. Yes, you can directly say this approximation. You can directly write this. It's a stretching wali case. You can directly write this. For stretching wali case, r proportional to l square, r proportional to 1 upon a square, because material is going to remain constant, that you know. So for stretching wali case, r proportional to 1 upon r proportional to l square and r proportional to 1 upon a square. For stretching wali case, r proportional to 1 upon a square and r directly proportional to l square, inversely proportional to area square, directly proportional to length square, directly proportional to length square and inversely proportional to area square. So I have repeated it so many times so that you can remember it. Next, temperature dependence of resistivity. Write down the heading: temperature dependence, temperature dependence of resistivity. Okay, resistivity. Temperature dependence of resistivity. That is very simple. Rho is equal to rho zero. Of course, for metals they shall say yes. For metallic conductors, that's what I was saying. It should be a metal, metallic conductor. It should not be only conductor. It should be metallic conductor. We are talking about conductors. In this chapter, we are going to talk only about conductors, nothing else. And it should be a metallic conductor. It is rho zero into bracket 1 plus alpha delta theta or delta T. If you want to call temperature as T, that is also okay. If you want to call temperature as theta, that is also okay. Rho zero into bracket 1 plus alpha theta. Final temperature is theta, initial temperature is zero. Rho is the resistivity or specific resistance at theta degree Celsius. Rho zero is the resistivity at 0 degree Celsius. Alpha. Now this alpha is temperature coefficient of resistivity. And same will work as temperature coefficient of resistance also, with of course slight modification. Slight modification. You can modify this equation. I will tell you how. Alpha is, for time being, this is temperature coefficient of resistivity, not resistance. Right now it is resistivity. Okay, it's the property of material at given temperature. Resistivity is a property of material at given temperature. If you change the material, resistivity will change. If you keep the material same, but if you change the temperature, if you keep the material same, but if you change the temperature, still the resistivity will change. Still the resistivity will change. Now you will say, sir, R is equal to rho L upon A. Yes. So right now we are not changing length and area, let's say. We are changing only temperature. Okay. Let's change temperature by keeping length and area constant. By keeping length and area constant, then length and area is constant, then R is going to be proportional to rho. Okay. Or rho will be proportional to R, just by mathematics. And let us put some proportionality constant there for time being. For time being. Or if you don't want to do
such kind of proportionality, that is also absolutely fine, no problem, no issues. You can write this R is equal to rho L upon A. You know L and A are going to be constant. Absolutely no problem. You know length and area are going to be constant. So replacement for rho will be equal to R into A upon L. So call this as equation number one. You can or this equation as equation number one. So equation one you can modify. For rho, write R A upon L. For rho zero, resistivity at 0 degrees Celsius, write rho zero, resistance at 0 degrees Celsius, A upon L. If this slight modification you do, everything else will remain same. Everything else will remain same. And now you can cancel out A by L, A by L. Now you will get that resistance wala formula. Temperature dependence of resistance. Here it is resistivity. Here it is resistance. The same alpha is working as temperature coefficient of resistance now. Reply in the chat box. Clear and written. Everyone, check kar, getting it? This we have done so many times, right? All right. But these relations are true for small change in temperature or small range in temperature, okay? Not very large change in temperatures. For example, temperature of resistance changing from 0 degrees Celsius to 500 degrees Celsius. No, for such large changes, this is not applicable, okay? This is not applicable, okay? So write down. These laws are valid for small changes in temperature. Not very small. This small by asa kahi nahi. By 1 degree Celsius, 2 degree Celsius, asa kahi nahi. You can go up to 100 degree Celsius. That is also. For small changes in temperature, for small changes in temperature, for small changes in temperature. Next question number 20, example number 20. The resistance of the thin silver wire, the resistance of the thin silver wire is 1.0 ohm at 20 degrees Celsius. So resistance is equal to 1.0. 1 ohm at temperature equal to 20 degrees Celsius. The wire is placed in the liquid bath, and its resistance rises to 1.2 ohm. Okay. Let us call this as initial resistance, initial temperature. Okay, now it has been placed in the liquid bath. Liquid bath means a liquid, just like temperature, higher temperature. And we know if the temperature of the metal increases, ultimately the number of collisions of electrons flowing in that metal with the atoms increases, and the resistance increases. Collisions what like flow of electrons na oppose just zala. So oppose just means resistance just. So temperature must have been increased, so resistance has been increased to 1.2 ohm. What is the temperature of liquid bath? Temperature of liquid bath is going to be equal to final temperature of the wire, because wire is kept in the liquid. So liquid and the wire both will have same temperature. So final temperature you are basically asked. Temperature of liquid bath is asked. It means actually final temperature you are asked. What you will do? Now you will say that, sir, which law we shall use? Because resistance at 0 degree Celsius we are not given. Resistance at 0 degree Celsius we are not given. So in that case, you have two options. Let us verify both of the options. You can write R is equal to R solution. Solution R is equal to R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha delta theta. And there you know initial resistance is the resistance at 0 degree Celsius. You can write R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha into theta minus 0. So that law modifies to R is equal to R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha into theta, right? Initial temperature, initial resistance 0 degree Celsius, final resistance theta degree Celsius. Of course, alpha of the wire is given in the question. Silver wire has alpha equal to 10 raised to minus 2 per degree Celsius. 10 raised to minus 2 per degree Celsius. Of course, per degree Celsius is not there. Temperatures or temperature change unit degree Celsius. Alpha unit 1 upon degree Celsius. Degree Celsius cancel. Unitless plus unitless. Unitless means unitless add value. So R is equal to R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha into theta. R equal to R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha into theta. So for the first case, we can write resistance in first case equal to resistance at 0 degree Celsius into bracket 1 plus alpha, whatever value that is, into this delta theta, which is it is theta, that is the temperature, that is equal to 20. Bracket complete. Alpha value we already know, call this as equation 1. And second resistance R2, you can write resistance at theta 2 is equal to resistance at 0 degree Celsius plus 1 plus alpha into final temperature theta 2 minus initial temperature 0. Here you could have written theta 2. Check kara zara samajhte ka? Kay chalu hai samajhte ka? Final temperature. Law tar apan tayar kela. Resistance at theta degree Celsius is resistance at 0 degree Celsius into bracket 1 plus alpha delta theta. Resistance at 0 degree Celsius 1 plus alpha 20. So at 20 degree Celsius resistance is R1. At theta 2 degree Celsius resistance is R2. Now you have only one unknown theta 2. If you divide this equation, you will get only one equation, one unknown. Right now you have two equations and you have two unknown, R0 and theta 2. You can divide these two equations. So R1 upon R2, you will get R0 cancelled. 1 plus alpha into 20 divided by 1 plus alpha theta 2. 1 plus alpha into theta 2. You can do the cross multiplication. Or let's write values of R1 and R2. R1 is 1 ohm, R2 is 1.2. So 1 upon 1.2. 1 plus alpha into 20 divided by 1 plus alpha into theta 2. Do the cross multiplication. 1 plus alpha into theta 2 is equal to 1 into 1.2, 1.2 plus 1.2 into 20. 1.2 into 20 is 24. Alpha as it is. Alpha is known, forget about it. So this one on the right hand side. So 1.2 minus 1 plus 24 alpha this alpha into theta 2 as it is. So theta 2 will be equal to this alpha in the denominator. 1.2 minus 1 is 0.2 plus 24 alpha as it is. This alpha in the denominator, 0.2 upon alpha plus this 24 as it is. Alpha alpha cancel. Alpha alpha cancel. 0.2 upon alpha. Alpha is 10 raised to minus 2 plus 24 plus 24. Check if I am right or wrong. This 10 raised to minus 2 in the numerator, that will become 100. 100 into 0.2, that is equal to 20 plus 24. That becomes 44 degree Celsius. 44 degree Celsius. Checker. This is the first way. This is the first way to do the exact calculations. Because law is this. Law says resistance at theta degree Celsius is equal to resistance at 0 degree Celsius into bracket 1 plus alpha delta theta. So correct answer shall be 44 degree Celsius. If in the option 44 is there, I will choose 44. This way is more accurate. This way is more accurate. But what if this 44 degree Celsius is not in the option? What if this 44 degree Celsius is not in the option? In that case, you will not involve this resistance at 0 degree Celsius in the question. Your question madhe tumhi 0 degree Celsius cha resistance la involve karnar nahi. Right now we involved it and we took the ratio and we eliminated it. And then we found out the answer of final temperature. But there is other way. And with the other way, you will get another answer. With the other way, you will get another answer. But always verify with this that whether the answer given is present in the option or not, whether the option you found, whether the answer you found is present in the option or not. If not, then other way. Other way is just write final resistance is equal to initial resistance into bracket 1 plus alpha delta theta. Now this R is not the temperature, not the resistance at 0 degree Celsius. Now this R is, now this R1 is not the resistance at 0 degree Celsius. I will simply write final resistance 1.2, or let's write R2 as it is equal to R1 into bracket 1 plus delta theta, final temperature minus initial temperature. Delta theta, final temperature minus initial temperature. R2 is 1.2. R1 is 1 into bracket 1 plus delta theta, final temperature theta 2 to be found out as it is, minus initial temperature 20 degree Celsius. No need to convert the temperature, okay? Ultimately, it's going to be temperature difference. So no need to convert. Even if it is in Kelvin, that is also fine. It is going to be temperature difference. So everything works well with degree Celsius and Kelvin. If it is a temperature difference, the temperature difference asel the degree Celsius and Kelvin convergence chi garaj nahi. Now this is one equation, one unknown. No need to write this one. This one on the left hand side, that will become 0.2 is equal to this theta 2 minus 20. Check if I am right or wrong. I think I have forgotten that alpha. Yes, alpha, 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 we just forgot that alpha. No need to write this one. This one on the left hand side, that will become 0.2 equals alpha into bracket theta 2 minus 20. Don't put value of alpha here immediately, no need. First of all, rearrange equation for theta 2. This alpha on the left hand side, 0.2 upon alpha This minus 20 now can be brought on the left hand side, that will become plus 20. And then this theta 2 as it is. 0.2 upon alpha. Alpha is 10 raised to minus 2. Plus 20 is equal to theta 2. So theta 2 is equal to, chalte na right side left side lever, 0.2 upon 10 raised to minus 2. 10 raised to minus 2 in the numerator, 100 in the numerator, 0.2. Sorry, 10 raised to minus 2 in the numerator, 100, 0.2 into 100, 20, plus this 20, that equals 40. Initial answer was 44, now the answer is 40. If 44 is not in the option, then I shall choose 40. If 44 is not in the option, then I shall choose 40. Reply me in the chat box, clear and ready. Why do we get such change in answer? Because this is approximation of this. Approximation of this. This is exact, it's approximation this. This is exact, its approximation is this. Instead of resistance at zero, you are putting there resistance at theta 1 degree Celsius and taking theta 1 as a reference temperature rather than taking zero as a reference temperature. Okay, you are taking theta 1 as a reference temperature instead of taking zero as a reference temperature here, theta 1 as a reference temperature here, zero is a reference temperature. That's the reason. Done. Reply in the chat box, clear and written. Good. Question 21. The current voltage graph for a given metallic wire, current voltage graph for given metallic wire at two different temperatures T1 and T2 are shown in the figure. Current voltage means on the always Y versus X. Graph is always given as Y versus X. Y versus X. Current voltage graph is given for the same metallic wire at two different temperatures. At two different temperatures. IV graph of metallic wire at two different temperatures. At two different temperatures is given to you. Option A, option B, option C, option D. Here they have written greater, here they have written less. Tell me, A, B, C, D. Do it. Do it. What is the logic?
Okay.
What you can do is, you can, to compare temperatures T1 and T2, you can compare the slopes of the lines. So tan of theta 1 is more tan of theta 1, angle mota, tan mota. Tan of theta 1, or first of all what you can write is theta 1 is more than theta 2. Now theta is angle and not temperature. Theta 1 is angle, angle of this line with the x-axis. Theta 2 is angle of this line with the x-axis or the voltage axis. Tan angle mota asel tar tan pan mota. Tan of theta 1 is more than tan of theta 2. But here tan theta means change in y slope. Tan theta means slope. Change in y coordinate upon change in x coordinate. Let's say here the coordinates are I, v or I1, v1. So change in y coordinate is change in y coordinate I should have written it like this. X coordinate is v1 at this point and y coordinate is i1, and at any point on this wire x coordinate is v2, y coordinate is let's say i2. काय नाही वायर वरचे पॉइंट्स घ्याल. स्लोप कसा काढतात? चेंज इन वाय कॉर्डिनेट मायनस चेंज इन एक्स कॉर्डिनेट. टेक दिस एज अ फायनल पॉइंट अँड देन फाइंड चेंज इन वाय कॉर्डिनेट. आय वन मायनस झिरो डिवाइडेड बाय चेंज इन एक्स कॉर्डिनेट व्ही वन मायनस झिरो. दिस व्हॅल्यू मस्ट बी मोर दॅन टॅन ऑफ थीटा टू. टॅन थीटा टू म्हणजे स्लोप. स्लोप कसा काढतात? चेंज इन वाय कॉर्डिनेट अपॉन चेंज इन एक्स कॉर्डिनेट. If you are taking this as a final, then 0 minus I2, change in y coordinate, and change in x coordinate will be 0 minus V2. Or if you are taking this as a final point, then change in y coordinate is I2 minus 0 divided by V2 minus 0. I1 upon V1 more than I2 upon V2. If you take the reciprocal, then inequality changes, right? 1 upon 3 is more than 1 upon 5. That is okay. But if you take the reciprocal, inequality changes. So take the reciprocal. Inequality changes. Left chi right la geli. V1 upon I1 is the resistance at temperature T1 is less than V2 upon R2 is resistance at temperature T2. Okay. We know for metals more temperature, more resistance. It's a metallic wire. For metals, temperature more implies resistance more. So if R2 is more, then T2 is more. If R2 is more, then T2 is more. Reply in the chat box, clear and written. Step by step, all these steps, one by one. Everyone. Good. Good. काही टेंशन नाही, निवांत गीत सुटतात ती आरामात. सुटतात ना गणित निवांत? यस नो एव्हरी वन? काही एफर्ट घेतोय का आपण? विथ मिनिमम एफर्ट्स वी आर डुईंग दिस. यू आर ऑब्झर्विंग आजचं लेक्चर कसं अगदी शांतपणे झालं. यू आर मॉडेलिंग द क्वेश्चन, वी आर अप्लाइंग व्हॉट एव्हर वी हॅव लर्न्ड अँड दॅट टू विथ ईज, राईट? क्वेश्चन नंबर 21 झाला ना? क्वेश्चन नंबर 21 झाला. लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द टुडेज लेक्चर अँड देन वी स्टॉप. चला बाळांनो क्वेश्चन नंबर 22 अँड देन वी स्टॉप. लेट्स ऍट लीस्ट सी व्हॉट्स गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. यू कॅन सॉल्व दॅट आफ्टर द क्लास, आफ्टर ऑल द लेक्चर्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर 22. चलो. द रेजिस्टन्स ऑफ द कंडक्टर at 20 degree celsius is 3.15 ohm. temperature 20 degree celsius, resistance 3.15 ohm. theek hai. and at 100 degree celsius 3.75 ohm. and at 100 degree celsius call this as theta 1, call this as theta 2. And at 100 degrees Celsius, now we have to call this as R1, call this as R2. Initially, call it as theta and R. But another theta and R is given in that case. If another theta and R is given in that case, call theta 1, R1, theta 2, R2. It is 3.75. Increase zala baba. 3.75. Zala, it is 3.15, 3.75.
Determine the temperature coefficient of resistance. And the resistance of the conductor at 0 degree Celsius.
Okay. R0 is equal to question mark. That is resistance at 0 degree Celsius. Now, it's a two equation, two unknown problem. Two unknowns, alpha and R0. Now, you know resistance at theta degree Celsius is equal to resistance at 0 degree Celsius into bracket 1 plus alpha into, no need to write delta theta because initial temperature is 0, final temperature is theta, so theta minus 0. And now you will write for the first case resistance R1, reference resistance at 0 degree Celsius into bracket 1 plus alpha, initial temperature 20 degree Celsius. This is the first equation. For the second case, resistance is R2, reference resistance at 0 degree Celsius into bracket 1 plus alpha, final temperature is 100 degree Celsius. R1 is given, R2 is given, R0 is asked, R0 is asked, alpha is asked, alpha is asked. Only R0 and alpha, these are the two unknowns. You can take the ratio, R0 will get eliminated, then only alpha will be the unknown. Do the cross multiplication, find out the alpha, get the alpha, put the alpha in equation 1 or equation 2. Kutla tari eka equation madhe alpha taka. R1 mahit hai, R1 is already known. Put the value of alpha, get the value of R0. Reply in the chat box, clear and written. Method is also, further method is also clear. Take the ratio R0 eliminate. R0 eliminate zala, alpha kalto. Alpha yat taka, kutlya ekat taka. Equation 1 kiwa 2. R0 yat taka, sorry. Alpha yat taka, R0 milwa. Everyone now reply in the chat box. Are the things taught, all the things taught in today's lecture clear to all of you? Everyone fast. Pat answer by Janmala. Yes, you can reply in the chat box. Fine. Now, whatever yesterday's homework was given to you, complete that homework. Okay, complete that homework. Okay, and that will automatically prepare you for the test. Okay, chalo bye. In this lecture, we'll stop at this point. Okay, have a good day and nice day to all of you. Chalo bye.